my family is the Anderson's family, and the Anderson's family is my family. My parents and Jason's parents were friends and best friends, almost literally for life.
And 4th of July passed, that time had snow on it, and I remember Jason was so excited because he was going to see snow, he'd be able to play in snow for the first time. It was so excitement.
How do you feel?
Nervous. Excited and nervous.
What part of this, everything's made you nervous? The commitment or everybody watching you or being with somebody you know that you love for the rest of your life?
I think the last part. Because I know it's an important day for me. It's the most important day in my life. That's why, and I don't want to cry.
She would look amazing in any light to me. She's my soulmate, my best friend for life. So it doesn't matter what she looks, she's gonna be beautiful no matter what.
We are gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love, and to add our best wishes to the words which shall unite Rodica and Jason in marriage. We are here not only to witness your commitment to each other, but also to wish you both every happiness in your future life together. Within its framework of commitment and loyalty, marriage enables the establishment of a home where through trust, patience, and respect, the love and affection which you have for each other may develop into a deep and lasting relationship. We who are witnessing your marriage hope that despite the stresses inevitable in any life, that your love, respect for each other, your trust and understanding of each other will increase your contentment and heighten your joy in living. Let us pray. We thank you, God, for being with us here today and ask you for your blessing on this couple as they step forward and make this lifetime commitment to each other. Lend them your wisdom and help guide them on their path. We pray. Amen.
No, you know that I was named after your father. Yes. As I was growing up, it was one of my pride that your father was a pilot, and as I knew it, as I had few chances to meet him, he was filled with wisdom, and I always loved listening to him. And a few weeks ago, I was sitting at a retreat and thinking about him and your wedding, Rodica, and I started to write. And this is what I came up with. If I were your dad, I would first say how proud I am of the man you are becoming every day. If I were your dad, I would tell you that this is big moment in everyone's life, and you should never forget how you feel right now. If I were your dad, I would ask, is Rodica your best friend? The one you want to tell all your secrets to, the one you think of when you awake, and the last one you want to see when you go to sleep. If I were your dad, I would remind you that actions and words are always reflected back. So be trustworthy, kind, gentle, and loving, and that is how she will treat you. If I were your dad, I would remind you that life is a journey. Who you and Rodica are today is not who you will be in 5, 10, or 15 years from now. So leave room in your relationship for growth. If I were your dad, I'd remind you to leave more time for poetry and wisdom and less time for getting your way and desires. If I were your dad, I would remind you that you already know all there is to know about love because you've been loved from the moment you were born. Those would be my words of advice to you on your wedding day, if I were your dad.
How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee to the depth and breadth and height my soul can reach. When feeling out of sight for the ends of being his ideal grace. A lovely, lovely to the level of every day's most quiet needs by sun and candlelight. I love thee freely, as men strive for right. I love thee purely, as they turn from praise. I love thee with the passion put to use in my old griefs, and with my childhood's faith. I love thee with the love I seem to lose with my saints, with my lost saints. I love thee with the breath, smiles, tears of all my life, and if God choose, I shall but love thee better after death.
At this time, I would ask that each of you light the two candles that stand for you as individual persons. Represent the light of your individual souls and also your separate families and sets of friends that each of you bring to the marriage. With these flames, I ask that in a moment you light a new and brighter light, which is your candle of unity. As you light the candle that represents the new life you will share, your own light will not be extinguished. Indeed, your marriage will be made stronger by the richness you bring to it as individuals. Go ahead and light your unity candle. The flames that are kindled here are precious, for they are symbols of the light that shines within you. As the years go by, you must tend all three flames to keep the light of your marriage strong and bright.
Jason, please place this ring on Rodica's finger and repeat after me. Rodica, I give you this ring.
Rodica, I give you this ring.
To wear upon your hand as a symbol of our love and unity. With this ring, I marry you.
With this ring, I marry you.
By virtue of the authority invested in me as the Commissioner of Civil Marriages, I now pronounce that you are married. Jason, you may kiss your bride.
Is a feeling that you feel, but if you open up, no, I won't let you fall, my dear. Under the surface, we're all just the same. Follow me, darling, for you I'll be brave, oh Lord. Love is a feeling that you feel. Take your time. I promise I'll return it.